Elite Facts presents
7 more dark theories that will ruin your childhood shows and films.
7.
SpongeBob and Friends represent the 7 deadly sins. You may remember in another video we did that we said the characters in the long-running Nickelodeon hit SpongeBob SquarePants are actually mutants who were victims of a nuclear bomb blast. That theory alone is pretty strange in its own right, and although this theory certainly isn't the creepiest on this list, it's still pretty interesting considering how accurate these characters portray each deadly sin. However, that's not the only theory relating to the beloved kids show. The show follows the adventures of the titular Sponge and his many friends, including a starfish, a crab, and his pet snail, as they explore Bikini Bottom. And the series has actually won numerous awards and spawned a franchise comprised of feature films, theme park rides, and even a short film competition. So, where does the 7 Deadly Sins theory fit in? Well, the theory is as follows. Mr. Krabs is the greedy business owner. Clarinet playing Squidward is the wrathful next-door neighbor. SpongeBob lusts for life and loves all of those around him just a bit too much. Gary is the gluttonous cat. Patrick is the sloth-like dope. Plankton is envious of Mr. Krabs and his success. And Sandy is the prideful squirrel from Texas. These certainly aren't exact. Squidward is more grumpy and annoyed than full of hate. And Gary is, like most pets, simply interested in fulfilling basic needs, like eating.
6.
Toy Story 3 is about the Holocaust. Alright, hear us out on this one, and don't take this the wrong way. The film legitimately tugged at our heartstrings. I mean, that ending was legit almost like watching your childhood die. We wanted everything to be okay, just like everyone else in the theater. But this theory is very controversial, to say the least, and the comparison between the film's story and the Holocaust is pretty damn creepy. The theory is as follows. The toys are all gathered up and taken away. They hide in an attic. They face possible death in a furnace. They're saved after finding a new homeland, etc., etc. These are all images that conjure up intense, horrific historical memories for a lot of people. But it is hard to imagine the Toy Story team at Pixar gathering around a table and firmly deciding that the third movie in the trilogy of films for children, not the first, not the second, but the third, would be the appropriate time to finally tackle one of the most horrible genocides in history. Another theory relating to Toy Story is that it shares a lot of plot elements with The Walking Dead, such as Rick and Woody both being sheriffs, Woody and Buzz both getting into a fight far away from where they live, much like Shane and Rick when they're 18 miles away from the farm, and so on and so forth. This is definitely a coincidence, but we highly recommend checking out the video comparing the two. It's pretty damn interesting and hilarious, to say the least.
5.
Fairly Odd Parents are just antidepressants to Timmy. So on the surface, The Fairly Odd Parents is a pretty goofy yet fun-loving show that follows an ordinary boy named Timmy who has an actual pair of fairy godparents, husband and wife duo Cosmo and Wanda. They grant him wishes, give him advice, and help him get out of the trouble that's caused by his wishes. There are a lot of rules to the fairy godparent arrangement, of which secrecy is an important part, and Timmy is often almost discovered by his evil babysitter Vicky and his equally awful teacher Mr. Crocker. Timmy's parents are pretty clueless, and usually they're far too busy to know what's going on with their son. This is likely the starting point for this theory, as there may be more to this show than what we're actually seeing. The theory suggests that Timmy is depressed, and Cosmo and Wanda represent Zoloft and Prozac, respectively. They appear when he starts struggling to deal with the problems in his life, and while they don't make them go away completely, they do make them seem easier for Timmy to handle.
4.
The Rugrats are just a figment of Angelica's tortured imagination. Talk about straight up ruining someone's childhood. This is a popular theory that has been circulating the internet for a while now, and it's pretty damn dark. So, do we really need to explain what Rugrats was? This show was essentially a staple for anyone who grew up in the mid-1990s and early 2000s. It was cute, it was harmless, and it had a lot of charm to it. But because the internet has to be the internet, people started theorizing that this innocent show had a much, much darker side to it. Apparently, because Angelica has no real, meaningful connection with family or loved ones, she constructs younger, literally infantile playmates to belittle as an outlet for her rage. Thus, the babies are all actually dead or made up. Tommy died soon after childbirth, Chucky died in the car crash that killed his mom, and Phil and Lil are Angelica's bizarre imaginary reaction to hearing the news that their mother had a stillborn baby. Oh, Internet, why do you have to ruin everyone's childhood? This is why we can't have nice things.
3.
Donald Duck suffers from post-traumatic stress disorder. Yeah, this one is a bit of a strange one. However, a lot of the evidence does point to him actually having PTSD. From the Journal of Cartoon Overanalyzations comes this diagnosis for Donald Duck's erratic behavior, though not for his epidemic of pantslessness. He has post-traumatic stress disorder, induced when he was a paratrooper in World War II. As the theorist notes, he seems to have fairly regular flashbacks, difficulty responding normally to social stimuli, and, quote, persistent symptoms of increased arousal, e.g. difficulty falling or staying asleep, anger, and hypervigilance, not to mention a total disinterest in talking about his wartime experiences.
2.
WALL-E destroyed Earth. Who doesn't like WALL-E? He's such a sweet and cuddly robot who just happens to be stuck in a post-apocalyptic setting. Or is he a merciless scavenger molding the new world to his liking? Oh wait, turns out he's evil. Well, according to one Reddit user anyway, and the theory actually makes a little sense. This is the last time we trust anything adorable. So according to this theory, the Earth Recovery Act was going perfectly fine until one WALL-E unit went rogue. Goddamn rogue droids, they simply can't be trusted, dammit. Anyway, this particular unit wasn't very good at its job, often refusing to crush particular objects. Instead, it wanted to keep these trinkets as treasures. However, all the other units were still indiscriminately compacting everything, including trinkets this particular WALL-E wanted. So this rogue unit began destroying all the other units and cannibalizing their parts. Suddenly, WALL-E seems pretty damn scary. It continued its senseless cannibalism until there weren't enough WALL-E units left to combat the growing problems of Earth. Its continued cannibalism allowed this rogue unit to go on operating long past its original operational lifespan, continuing to function for well over 700 years. Alone, he can now selectively pull out and protect his trinkets, while still compacting all the rest of Earth's junk. The reason why there is still so much trash on Earth despite 700 years of compacting is because all the other compactors were killed early on, and thus for 700 years only one unit has been working on the trash instead of a whole planet worth of units. We hate to say this, but we agree with Will Smith and iRobot now. Robots can't be trusted.
1.
Willy Wonka is a cannibalistic murderer. Okay, in all honesty, Willy Wonka is just a strange, strange man altogether, especially the Johnny Depp version, but let's forget that one ever happened and concentrate on the original Willy Wonka movie. But have you ever considered the fact that maybe Wonka isn't just a strange and awkward person, but rather he's a psychopath? Well, that's what some internet users believe. When you really think about it, Wonka's chocolate factory may produce the best chocolate in the world, but it's very much an accident-prone work environment that can easily lead to a child getting severely injured and could lead to possible death. I mean, he didn't exactly panic when Augustus Gloop got sucked up into that fudge tube. The kid could have easily suffocated or drowned in that chocolate river. Many people believe that the tube led to some kind of incinerator and that the poor boy burned to death. The theory also mentions how eerily wide the pipes in the factory are, almost as if Wonka anticipated that a child would end up being sucked into the pipe. It's also believed that Wonka intentionally fed children gum which had side effects that included turning children into fruits. He would then send those children to the juicing room to be juiced. The theory also states that during the boat scene, the boat had two vacant seats, which is of course peculiar, almost as if Willy had the knowledge that some of his visitors would vanish from the boat. What makes this theory even more disturbing is the fact that when Wonka was asking for his visitors to sign some waivers in case of accidents, he only asks the children to sign the waivers, almost as if he was specifically targeting them in his attempt to making them into candy. Did we miss any other creepy childhood-shattering theories? Well, let us know in the comments below, and thanks for watching!
Don't forget to like us and subscribe for more Elite Facts.